Wow, that was fun. Wow, that was worth our time, huh? That was really worth our time. I'm glad we watched that. Wow, that was fun. I'm glad I was up for that. Glad we all sat through 3 hours of that. That was a lot of fun, wasn't it? Wasn't that a lot of fun, everybody? Watching Monday Night Raw, wasn't that fun? I don't even have the fucking donations on yet. I don't even have the goddamn window open. Because I'm fucking watching this pile of shit. Wow, that was a great show. They really seemed to give a fuck, didn't they? They seemed to really give a fuck. Kind of like our government here in the United States doesn't give a fuck about us. This fucking company doesn't give a fuck about the fans. What's up with that? The government and the fucking company doesn't give a fuck about the fans. I'm going to fucking lose my fucking mind tonight. I hope Antifa takes this country out. And I hope the WWE's Raw's ratings decline down to fucking shit. I hate this fucking country. I hate this world. I hate this fucking show. I hate this fucking year. This piece of shit year we're living in right now. I hate YouTube. I said this would happen. You know, you make your own way on YouTube, and they're going to pass bill after bill after bill after bill to take out YouTubers, going back to the ads. The ads revenue. Do you remember when I made $100 a day in ad revenue? Remember that? But then the adpocalypse happened because PewDiePie said some things. Yeah, I don't think so. And remember when they banned all the fucking bullshit on YouTube if it was like about kids or something like that, and now you can go to jail for that? Yeah, it's all bullshit. It's Hollywood doing it. It's Disney doing it. It's Hollywood doing it. That's what it fucking is. It's Disney and Hollywood doing this shit. That's what they're doing. Hell, Joe Biden's about to appoint a guy from Disney, Bob Iger, a fucking scumbag criminal, in his fucking cabinet. They're fucking giving trillions of dollars to foreign countries in the COVID bill. They're going to make it a 10-year felony if you stream certain music. Or you could go to jail and it's a felony if you stream music. WWE Raw tonight thinks that bringing the legends back, that will do it. Yeah, bring the legends back. Of course. I can't even believe this because I've said this a million fucking times for years and years and years. Every time the fucking ratings crash, here comes Goldberg, here comes Lesnar, here comes Stone Cold Steve Austin. I'm sitting here with a fucking sinus infection, taking fucking goddamn fucking moxicillin with a fucking sinus infection. Half of my fucking tooth came off tonight as well, on top of that. And this is what we're doing. This is the fuck what we're doing tonight. WWE. I've said this a zillion fucking times. Vince McMahon, oh, it's Legends Night. Yes, bring back the Legends so we can see what a shit show we're dealing with. But they're not even bringing back the Stone Colds and the Rocks. They're bringing in Hogan and all this other shit. It doesn't matter. Even Hogan is more interesting than the current people. Absolutely fucking atrocious attempt at an effort. They purposely mailed this show in, so this doesn't even bother me that much. This doesn't surprise me at all. Oh, they just said fuck it. Okay, I get it. But then to announce Legends Night, and they're going to bring back these fucking legends. Go fuck yourself, Vince McMahon. Suck my fucking dick, you old fucking piece of maggot shit. You fucking cunt. Fuck you, Bruce Pritchard. Even though you're fucking subbed to my channel, you and fucking goddamn Connor or fucking fat fuck or whatever his name is. Fuck you. Fuck you, Bruce Pritchard. Fuck you. Fuck you in your fucking dickhole. You WrestleMania 9 nincompoop cunt fuck. Bruce Pritchard, you stupid bitch face fuck. You fat fucking piece of shit. And Road Dogg. Oh, Road Dogg. All the years, Road Dogg, that you said shit to me. Oh, you don't know what you're talking about, Joe. You don't understand, Joe. Good thing I'm not being in charge. You don't know. Yeah, where are you, down in NXT? Losing to AEW? Oh, you didn't know? Yeah, your ass better call somebody. His name is Joe Cronin, and he would do a better job than you. Triple H, Road Dogg, with your fucking bland NXT fucking product that can't beat AEW, and fucking AEW's about to beat Raw. You stupid cunt-tarded fucking idiots. You cunt-tards. You're fucking cunt-tards. You're if a pussy was so fucking mangled when the fucking baby came out of the womb and the doctor looked down and said, I don't know what the fuck this is. It's a cunt-tard is what it is. It ain't a fucking mongoloid. It ain't a fucking transvestite. It ain't a man, a woman, a male, a female. It ain't a fucking eunuch. It's a fucking cuntard. It's a fucking pussyhole that's mangled and mongoloided straight to fucking hell. That's what it is, you stupid fuck, you bald piece of shit. Triple H, Paul Levesque. You didn't hire me, but you hired Vic Joseph, a boring fuck who sucks dick. That's who you fucking hired, you fucking altered beast piece of shit. Fuck you, Paul Levesque, you fucking cracker honky bitch face fuck with your fucking mustache. Fuck you, and fuck Stephanie with her fucking stupid, hey, the women, Susan B. Coleman, we steal people's money. Fuck you. Fuck you and your asshole and your face and your fucking body. And fuck Shane McMahon for allowing this to go on. Slap your stupid fucking sister in the face. Slap your stupid fucking father in the face. And slap that fucking 90s wash-up Bruce Pritchard in his fucking mongled fucking little fat face. And his fucking red retard face. And his fucking stupid brother love. Slap him in his fucking face. Oh, wasn't it funny when brother love showed up at Money in the Bank and a clown was in the corner? Ooh, like Doink the Clown. Yeah, the guy you love so much. WrestleMania 9. I'm seeing double vision. Yeah. Oh, WrestleMania 9. That was a good one. Remember when it barely sold out and you gave all the tickets to a bunch of celebrity rich cum-sucking golfing fucks who didn't even know what wrestling was? What a great crowd at WrestleMania 9 it was, you dumb fucking midget cunt. Fuck you, you stupid fucking idiot. Yeah, real great job at Money in the Bank. Oh, look, the briefcase is gonna fall, and it's gonna land on Otis's lap, and Otis is gonna go, ooh, yummy, my big fat belly, I found a fucking briefcase, blah, blah, blah. Now Otis don't pat his belly anymore, does he? What does Otis do? Oh, I'm gonna just, my money in the bank's on the line, I guess. Oh, I lost it to The Miz. Oh, great, The Miz has the money in the bank. Wow. Oh, The Miz, I'm going to cash in now. The bell's not going to ring like it does every other time there is a cash in. You can watch WrestleMania to see that that actually happens with Seth Rollins and Brock Lesnar. Oh, yes, you can. Yes, you can. You motherfucking faggots. Yeah. Oh, I'm going to cash in my money in the bank now. Oh, the bell didn't ring, so it doesn't count on Raw. It doesn't count because the bell didn't ring. Oh, for the 5,000th time, the bell didn't ring. Ha ha, you all thought I was cashing in. There was like 50 minutes, but the bell didn't ring, so it didn't count. Oh, I'm going to grab my money in the bank and run away now. Oh, it wasn't a cash in. I'm Braun Strowman.
I'm the smartest, biggest dude you ever seen. I'm going to tell you when I'm cashing it in. I'm going to tell you I'm cashing it. Oh, I lost. I lost. Oh, I'm a big fucking...
Hey, Braun Strowman, go fucking with your stupid Republican guns and go kill some animals and take pictures of them on Instagram where you can actually feel like you're a tough guy and pick up the deer's head and go, oh, look at that dead deer. I'm a great guy. Yeah, Fuck you, Braun Strowman, you fucking tall, cum-guzzling fuckface. You stupid fuck. You're bigger than I could ever dream to be, but you're fucking dumb as fuck. And you're less entertaining than watching my neighbor play with his dick in his bathroom on a Sunday night after having a little too much marijuana. He's listening to Jimmy Buffett dancing around, forgetting that the entire window's open and old Joe's on his porch having a little smoky, and there he is. And I'm staring at it, and I'm forced to see it. I ain't trying to peer, I ain't trying to stalk, but I did see the cock. And oh, rubber ducky, you're so fun. You make bath time lots of cum. Oh, rubber ducky, it's going all over the place. What in the world is going on in Connecticut? What kind of fucking COVID strain is going on in Connecticut? I want to ask you right the fuck now. What kind of COVID strain is going on in Connecticut? Bobby Lashley, you big muscled mongoloid fuck with your beady eyes looking like a fucking owl who's afraid to suck its own dick. Bobby Lashley, you'd just be lucky that I didn't finish wrestling school and get more muscular, or I'd slap that fucking owly look off your stupid face. And MVP, you cum-guzzling fuck. You have proven tonight, MVP, that you should have been in jail a long time ago. You should have broken into someone's house and ended up killing them. And you should have stayed in jail and never succeeded anywhere. Because if this is what succeeding looks like, then I'd rather be raped, fucked, and murdered by a fucking intruder than have to watch you for another second on my TV. The Hurt Business. Woo! Look out for them. Wow! Thank God the good guys are here to save us, though. So here comes the Hardy Bros. The Hardy Bros. Bro, what are we gonna do, bro? Bro. Oh, I need to search within my spirit. Within my beliefs of myself. What the fuck are you saying, Jeff Hardy, you fucking idiot?
I don't know, man. Match is not here. I'm just collecting a paycheck. This is great. I got a paycheck. Hey, Joe, remember when you met me and you loved the fuck that owl thing that me and Matt did? Yeah. Well, fuck all that. Now it's just called collect that payment. I just collect that payment, and sometimes I get drunk and almost kill people. That's what I do now. Yeah.
Bro, let me tell you, bro, we're really gonna get over, bro, with the audience, bro. Hey, did we just set the record for the lowest, like, rating? Yo, step in the ring with me, Matt Riddle. I'm gonna fuck you up. And I'm gonna fuck you up so bad that when you go back to the store to buy your little smoky next week, you're gonna be ordering fucking wood chips. You fucking idiot. No more purple haze for you. No more drunk driving for Jeff. Just a straight up old beatdown from Joe Cronin in the middle of the ring. And the fact that you aren't getting jail time for like 5 years, Jeff Hardy, because you're a special little athlete celebrity guy, I'm gonna do what the United States government couldn't do. I'm gonna put your ass away for good, you stupid fuck. That's what I'm gonna fucking do. That's what I'm gonna fucking do to you, Jeff Hardy, you cum-guzzling cunt nugget. All right? I got a bad fucking voice box right now. It don't feel that good. I got a fucking severe infection in my face. My tooth just cracked in half. I found out that the fucking mascot of this show, Larry Funk, has passed away. And here I am with more fire in my ass than you and Mr. Keith Lee, you fucking boring fuck. Mr. Nice Guy, hit it up, Conan. Tell him, you fuck. Tell him, Conan. No!
Yeah, I didn't like his outfit, and I wasn't a big fan of his promo either, the Mr. Gentleman promo.
Right, type.
Allow me to introduce myself. Are you going to fuck the guy?
Allow me to introduce myself. Are you going to fuck the guy, or are you going to fight him? Keith Lee, are you going to fuck him, or are you going to fight him? Vince McMahon, are you trying to kill your company? Is this just the XFL number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, McMahon? Oh, you're going to bring back the legends? You're going to bring back old Hulkamania? You're going to bring back Stone Cold Steve Austin? You're going to bring back all these people? Well, guess what, Vince? It ain't going to fucking help when every week you do the same bullshit. It sucks dick, you fucking idiot. What the fuck does it matter? Oh, you boosted your little rating for 1 week. Who gives a shit? You stupid asshole idiot. Oh, I'm bleeding. Here's Vince McMahon to give me some Band-Aids. Because that's what Vince thinks. Band-Aids. What are you, Mike Pence? I'm going to walk around a hospital without a mask on. During COVID, I'm the vice president, but I need to walk around the hospital without a mask on. Vince, are you fucking delusional like your Republican vice president, Mike Pence? And fuck the Democrats, too. Fuck you to the Democrats, the Republicans, to this fucking country who's giving millions and billions of dollars to other countries. Why? We don't know. Why are we paying for a border wall? We don't know. Why are we paying to other countries? We don't know. Why is it now a felony if you stream music on YouTube and you can go to jail for 10 years? I don't know. Why did they insert the Patriot Act back in the fucking bill in Congress in 2004 when we went to Iraq? I don't know. Where were the weapons of mass destruction? I don't know. Why did 9/11 happen? I don't know. I do know. It's all bullshit. Why did all of these cunts sign this fucking bill and not even fucking read it? And if they did read it, then they're really assholes. The same reason why Monday Night Raw sucks dick. The same reason. And you got dumb fucking cunts on Twitter blaming Republicans and blaming Democrats. It's all of them, you stupid fucking idiots. I got people blaming Democrats for the fucking, for the felony shit. Well, guess what? It's a Republican. I'm gonna lose my mind, Jake. I think I might have just lost my voice, bro.
I think you did indeed, but I don't know how to top that. God damn. I mean, just damn. You said a lot. I listened. I processed.
I think I might have blown my voice now. I think I might have blown my voice out, bro.
You blew the microphone. That's for sure. Holy hell. I just wanted a good Raw. After TLC last night, I felt like they're so desperate with a record all-time low rating result last week that they're going to do something big. They have to. Vince knows, you know. Apparently USA is down his throat and everybody wants things, you know.
I'm going to be down his throat.
The locker room
isn't
happy.
I'm going to be down his throat soon.
You know, the investors aren't happy. The board of directors aren't happy. Creatives, no one's happy, and certainly not the fans. People are you know, watching less and less frequently. It's just a bad scenario. They know this. So we go into tonight, and you figured they would try and start out with something big, explosive, not Charlotte Flair. And then they even openly mock her sounding like a robot. That entire opening promo was beyond insulting to watch. It was embarrassing. It was cringy. It was so heavily scripted. No one sounded believable. The whole thing was a total disaster. And then by the time we actually got into the match, it was like I so badly, you know, was affected by everything that they said that I mentally tuned out at that point. And in certain points, the match didn't seem like it was that bad. But you get so frustrated by the buildup to it, or lack thereof, you don't even want to watch the damn thing. The only thing that we can take away from this episode that was anything worthwhile to me was Alexa Bliss. Orton's kind of okay, but I like the Alexa Bliss stuff. That's pretty much the only thing I really fully enjoyed.
I'm out of breath. How long was that rant?
Couple minutes for sure.
All right, listen. Alexa Bliss was gold tonight. That's so nice. Now shut up, Alexa. Not you, you dumb cunt. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck the U.S. Fuck Raw. Fuck WWE. Fuck the government. Fuck everybody. Just fuck everybody, dude. Fuck everything to hell and fuck everybody. Fuck me.
Bliss is the standout. And apparently, if this thing is like 6,000 pages or whatever, and they only had several minutes to read it and go through it, So whoever wrote all this shit knew it, stuffed it in there so it would be overlooked. That's the worst part.
What were they fighting over then, like, if they didn't read it?
For they each wanted key features and certain things included. I don't know which side wanted what, but you know, one wanted to make sure that unemployment insurance was there. Another one wanted to make sure that, you know, you were getting a stimulus package. Another one, you know, so whichever side wanted such thing to happen, they, you know, they each wanted to find some type of agreeable middle ground.
Ugh,
that was why it ended up being a bipartisan agreement.
I gotta tell you, man, I'm not that shocked. I'm not that shocked that tonight was garbage. That they just didn't do anything. They just mailed it in.
But I'm shocked that I figured the night would be somewhat garbage, but I didn't think they would mail in every segment. Like, everything was either a repeat, a rehash, or, you know, something that we've again seen before. That's really what it comes down to for all of this tonight. We've seen these matchups. We've seen these matches. We've heard these stories. All of it, every last bit of it, we've seen in some way, shape, or form.
You know, back in the Attitude Era, they would have gone right to, like after what they did last night to The Fiend, they would have gone right into, like, the next part, whatever the next part is. They would have gone right into, like...
That's what everybody wants to tune in with. And then they leave you on a cliffhanger to watch to the very end of the show. So they will show you The Fiend thing, and then they'd show Alexa, and then, you know, at the very end of the show, they'd make sure you want to tune in to keep watching because of that reason. They used to do it with Austin all the time. He'd come out, he'd fight with Vince, and then, all right, well, then at the end of the show, you're in the main event facing Triple H, you know, and that kind of shit. So now you got to see Austin right away, and now you're also staying to the end to see him again.
Alexa Bliss is amazing at acting. I don't know who said she can't act. I think she's the best actress in the whole fucking company. They should have started the show with Randy Orton. They should have gone to the Alexa Bliss on the swing thing, and later on in the night, you should have seen what you think is The Fiend's eyeball or face or mouth or voice, and he should have been talking from somewhere and talking about something or vague or whatever's going to happen next or vague stuff or what he's going to do and what's coming and, you know what I mean, he's not dead and everything. And then they should have had that go on for the next week or two or three or whatever it has to be. And so, like, now there's this new reset in storyline, just like in the season of a movie or a show where, like, the villain or the good guy or somebody at the very end blows up and you don't know where they are, and maybe they're dead, maybe they're not, you don't know. And then for the first quarter of the next season, they're in a ditch somewhere and you don't know where. You know, it's stuff like that. Like, you don't know what's going on, but there's a story progressing. But instead, it was just really just Alexa being like, I don't know, you know, which is kind of similar to what I said. But again, leaving The Fiend off the air, fine, whatever, I guess. It's the Undertaker type of thing. Fine, but they had nothing else. They had nothing else tonight.
No, they had absolutely nothing else. Nothing to surprise you with, nothing to subvert expectations, nothing to, you know, give you that, oh, wow, you know, nothing. Nothing at all. And that's what I was so shocked with, because, I figured they would have something to walk away from this episode to talk about, something to discuss, and there wasn't. And literally, as we said, we've seen all of these matches over and over and over again. You know, Ricochet going through all of the members of, you know, Retribution. We've seen it. It's boring. He's losing, so it doesn't go anywhere. And then, you know, the Hardy Riddle stuff was extremely, extremely just,
oh my God,
to listen to. That was
what
so
are they
bad.
Doing? What in the world are they doing? That was terrible. Matt Hardy and Riddle was fucking awful. What the fuck are they doing? I can't, I'm sorry, bro. Matt Riddle looks great in the ring, and he looks like a fucking idiot, and Jeff looks like a bigger idiot, and that's, I mean, this
I
shit's
slay
crazy.
Bitches every day. The
midnight sky. You're gonna slay bitches every day. Every day. Ladies and gentlemen, it is our friend and lover, Robert Heller.
Love it so much. Ooh, you know it's true.
I slay bitches every day.
Send my greasy ass into outer space and rain.
Oh, yeah, Robert. Oh, I'm going to jail for playing this one because this is a copyright. I'm going to jail for 10 years. 10 years in jail.
Give us Alexa Bliss swinging on a swing for 3 hours, talking dirty to us, and we be good.
666 watching us right now. Yo, Robert Heller, thank you, bro. I agree, dude. I almost jerked off.
Yeah.
I almost jerked off.
That would have worked. I think that would have worked quite well. No one would have complained.
I was born to slay them bitches.
At least that was some, you know, continuation of story and a step in another direction with the rest of this. I mean, I'm glad they just had her acknowledge it. It felt like a
shit
logical
bomb.
Step.
Yeah.
1. Charlotte calling Basil a Basler. 2. Hardy segment sucked. 3.
Blazer.
Atrocious start. 4. Sheamus almost missed the table. 5. Camera missed a table spot. 7. Jackson Ryker beat.
Jackson Ryker beating Lucha Party. Jesus, Vince and Bruce. D. Welsh. Thank you, Welsh, for the $5. Becoming a $5 shit bum. I need to find some water somewhere. You know, just garbage.
What else we got?
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
This was one of the most enjoyable Raws in a very long time. I heard so much interesting things tonight. From Alejandro joining crack club to a drunk Canadian rambling to a masshole succumbing to his own herbs, this was a great 3-hour listen.
yeah, I mean, I have no idea. I have no idea anymore. The goon. What up, goon? I've lost my whole mind, goon.
Shit bomb.
I lost my voice ranting earlier.
This show will give you cancer, I swear. WWE caused COVID. Kill me. 2020 can choke on Nyla Rose's ball cheese. And fucking cake.
You know what, Spaz Phoenix, thanks for the $5. I hope they find out that Jackson Ryker used to, like, beat people that weren't white, and he's a racist, and he still gets, and he's still on TV. Just to watch the SJWs lose their minds. That's more entertaining than the show. Watching the SJWs freaking out. I hope more stuff comes out on Jackson Ryker. And they don't fire him. And then people just snap.
My broken ass might forget. Happy birthday, Spez.
Happy birthday, Spez.
My name is Kane and I'm donating.
The minute Charlotte started, Mandy got injured by that fat racist SJW pig near Jackson. Dana got pinned. He turned off my TV in disappointment. Fuck you, Vince. Fuck you, Stephanie, and fuck you, Triple H. Fuck you, Nia. I hope you get COVID and die from it.
Oh, Jesus. I wouldn't say that, but Jesus Christ. Bimbo Baggins, thanks for the 666.
But
I mean,
I understand the sentiment.
I was pretty intense earlier. Somebody, obviously, I'm going to have to go back and watch. I don't even remember what I said. That's one of those rants where I don't even know what I was doing. So I'll have to go back and watch that later. I'm sure I'll enjoy it. Bimbo Baggins, thanks for the 666.
What else we got?
I've lost my voice.
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Highlight of Raw was Danis Senton. Would have been funny, and I thought her and Mandy were about to do was reference Flair's tits when they said something looks different. Riddle is like one of those guys from Tough Enough where they get 30 seconds promo and suck.
Yeah, pretty, I mean, something. I don't know, man, but at least he's high to explain it. Like, he's, oh, I'm high, so that's why I'm a retard. Like, I'm high because I'm retarded. You know what I mean? If you guys want to donate tonight, link down below. Please tell me what you think about Raw.
You
want to
see my dick?
Stuff.
I'll take my dick out right now. I'm Sean's View Entertainment.
Take your dick out.
And you want to see my dick?
And YouTube won't even do anything.
Do you want to see my dick? I will show you my penis. I'm Sean's View. Don't screw with me or else I'll show you my penis.
So many times it happens too fast. You change your passion for glory, don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past, you must fight just to keep them alive. It's the eye of the tiger. It's the thrill of the fight. Mm. Rising up to the challenge of our rival.
Dun, dun, wow. Dun, dun.
I can't believe that donation. I mean, let me tell you something. We play that song, I'm going to go to jail for 10 years now, thanks to the new COVID stimulus. Thanks to the new COVID stimulus, I'm going to jail if we play that.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Want some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh,
happy birthday, Spaz.
A little bit of the bubbly.
Survivor lyrics. Thank you.
Have you heard about the 3-martini tax break for the rich or the tax break for horse owners and 17-year-old dependents get no money? Wait, the Korean War is still going on. WWE is America.
Yeah, bro. Let me tell you something. This COVID stimulus shows you that our country is just as retarded as Raw. Literally, that's all I can think about tonight, is how they're the same thing. You go, you bang your head and you go, how are they doing this on Raw? Why do they do this? Are they this fucking retarded stupid? Are they trying to fuck with us? The country is doing the same fucking thing. What the fuck, dude, did I read in this stimulus package, dude? Go read this fucking thing. What in the fuck is in this fucking thing? What the fuck is in this fucking... You want to do it? You want to fucking do it?
I gotta knock down the door in a second.
Come on, FBI, I'll kill you.
Rising up, back on the street. Took my time, took my chances. Went the distance, now I'm back on my feet. Just a man and his will to survive.
Go ahead and break this fucking door down. I'll fucking blow everything up. I'll blow my whole house up. And fucking bury my whole family in the backyard, and then I'll eat my own asshole alive in front of you on the news. I'll eat my own fucking asshole alive on the news. I'll fucking eat myself in front of you. I'll eat myself in front of you, motherfuckers. I'll eat my fucking... I'll eat myself in front of you.
He said he was going to eat himself in front of me.
On 911. I'm going to stick...
No, operator, I'm not kidding. He said eat himself in front of... Yeah.
I'm going to go fucking ask them if I can do the COVID vaccine live on YouTube stream in the nurse's office, and they'll be like, okay, yeah. And then when the lady's about to fucking poke me, I'm going to pull my arm away. I'm going to go, what do you fucking think you're doing? And she's going to be like, oh, I thought... Are you okay? You wanted the vaccine, the COVID vaccine, and you... You're live streaming. You said we could... We don't mind if you live stream it. It's fine. Oh, yeah? Yeah, I know that. But I want you to put it in my dick hole. I want you to give me the fucking COVID vaccine in my fucking dick hole. Did you hear me? I want it in my dick hole. I want it in my dick hole. Okay, did you hear me? That's right. We're watching Christmas Story. How long until that's banned on TV for racism? How long till fucking Christmas Story is gone from the TV? Go ahead. Put the fucking goddamn thing in my dick. Put the fucking thing in my dick. Put the fucking COVID vaccine right in my fucking dick. Bro,
that's where you got to go nuts.
What
you gotta
the
be
fuck?
Like, I said I wanted the vaccine. She's like, but this is the vaccine. Like, no, that's the tracking chip. I want the real vaccine. And you just got to freak out.
What the fuck is this, Jake? Page 5099 of the COVID relief bill, the reincarnation of the Dalai Lama. What the fuck is this? Go
There's
read
so
it.
Much weird
what the
shit
fuck
on there.
Is that? Explain me what the fuck that is. And explain to I me, don't... Mr. Retard Republican from North Carolina, why the fuck we're going to jail for 10-year felonies for fucking bullshit, you fucking rich scumbag piece of fucking big horse tooth fuck. With your big horse teeth, you fucking rich scumbag piece of shit. I'll fuck you with that flag behind you, you North Carolina fucking mongoloid fuck. Fuck you. Fuck North Carolina, you fucking hillbilly fucking cum-guzzling fuck. And what the fuck are the Democrats doing sending all this money to all these fucking countries? Fucking Nepal, yeah. Burma, Cambodia, and all this other shit. $1.7 billion
Asian relief fund that's like another billion. It's in its
$1.4 billion Asian reassurance. What the fuck is that?
Yeah, what the hell is that?
Explain to me what the fuck this is. And explain to me why we have fucking, we can't take money out of the fucking military budget. And explain to me the billions of dollars on the fucking border wall. Explain all this fucking shit. I got a border wall. It's called military lined up with weapons. That's my border wall. It's almost fucking free compared to the one you're putting up. You're actually putting up a fucking wall. You know what I do? I line up military personnel.
then you keep people employed. You actually can hire people to do it, you know? Then you,
yeah,
you create jobs, and, you know, there's so much, there's so many possibilities.
You want to sign up to come into the country? There's the fucking sign up over there. Get in line. You can get in line. It's cool. But you have to sign up, then turn around. Or fucking, you fucking put a wall up. It's doing, like, what the fuck are we doing? What the fuck is this? Explain
and
this
I
to me.
How
Vince McMahon, you're going to bring back the legends on Raw, Vince? Doesn't make any sense.
They go ahead and, you know, you're getting $600. You have to act like it's the greatest gift ever, in, you know, in the sense of, but if you say anything, oh, you're you know, taking, you know, looking a gift horse in the mouse kind of mouth idea. It's like, you know, you're not being unappreciative by any means, but you could still criticize the fact that the only amount of money they can come up to help everybody out is $600 now.
Yeah.
They people broke it down on Twitter. My dumbass forgets the facts, so I don't want to state it wrong. But there was one fund that they could go ahead and dismantle that is not being utilized at this point in time. If they did that, they can give every American $3,000.
Whoa.
You know, there's stuff they don't want to touch, like you said, for the military.
Does that mean I'd get $15,000 then, though?
It would go for you, the kids, all that stuff.
That'd be $15,000.
Drastically, you know?
I don't think, well, I'll be honest, I don't think, I mean, yeah, I'd like 15,000, but I don't think I need 15,000. But yeah, you're right, in a way. Maybe household or something like that. Like, you
yeah,
know.
I'm sure they would price it out for households and, you know.
But right now it's not. It's 600
wouldn't be that
a person.
Much for children, but for
$600. I'm getting three. It's 600 a person. I'd get 3,000.
Yeah.
I will get 3,000.
I don't know if the kids are getting 600 with this one, though, are they?
Are they not?
I don't know for sure. I heard a couple of conflicting things, and you never know what's the actual.
Oh, well, but yeah, if everybody got 3,000, then, like, I mean, shit, then we'd fucking. I mean, holy fuck! I'd probably
1,500 is better than 600 at this point. You know,
it, yeah, it's, but it's what's in the bill that's freaking me out. But it literally mirrors
people
Raw.
People needed this relief so badly that, of course, they use the guise of that to push this through, and that's
yeah.
what's so upsetting.
Just like
that, we've needed this relief for so many months. And
just like
now 9/11. What you're getting is barely a help at all.
We need to go to Iraq. They've got weapons of mass destruction. We need to go to Iraq. Oh, we need to put in the Patriot Act. We need the Patriot Act to keep all of us safe. We need the NSA and the Patriot Act to keep everybody safe. We need to be able to spy on you and just take you to jail at any point just because. Oh, we need the NSA. Oh, hey, Reagan, where's your trickle-down economics? Can we bring Ronald Reagan back to life so I can skull fuck him live on YouTube in front of everybody? Well, what you say is the triple down economics, and oh, I gave the fucking country away to the banks. I gave all the country away to the banks, and I gave you the greatest sales pitch you ever heard live on TV about the trickle down effect of economics. Oh my God. Thanks, Ronald Reagan, for giving the country to the banks. Oh, my God, trickle-down economics. Hey, George Bush, want to take us to Desert Storm and so we can play with the weapons that Dick Cheney's company made? We really need to make some more weapons and tanks and fucking missiles. Can we get Dick Cheney's fucking company somehow, can we get them to make a bunch of money off of war? Oh, fuck George Bush. You fucked up. Bill Clinton just became the president for 8 years. Don't worry. I'll take care of everything. Bill Clinton does a bunch of weird shit that destabilizes everybody even more, so they gotta buy the weapons from his company. And guess what? George Bush, he's coming back into office. It's his son, though. George Bush's son is coming into office. And guess what? He's bringing all the same people from when his dad was the president, and he took us to war with Iraq in Desert Storm. I'm bringing back all the same people. Colin Powell, Dick Cheney, I'm bringing them all back. And my name's Bush, just like my dad. But the American people are never going to want to go to war again. They hated that. That's why my dad lost. If we go to war again, I'll be voted out in 4 years. Unless we go to war and the people are behind it. How do we get the people behind a war? They'll never buy it. We could blow up our own buildings.
It's genius.
And then everybody will say America and put American flags on their front doorstep. Even the dumb Democrats will do it. Massachusetts. I remember all the American flags. Hey, where's the weapons of mass destruction? We never found them. Hey, Dick Cheney, where did we get all the tanks and weapons from? You're the vice president, Dick Cheney. Oh, Dick Cheney, your company is called Halliburton? And they make weapons and tanks and shit? And all your friends who invest in oil companies and weapons? That's going to be pretty good for you, isn't it, Dick? Hey, let's make the Patriot Act and make all this weird spy shit on the whole entire country and stop stem cell research because God told me so. Wow, this was great. What's that? Defensive missile went off to shut down and shoot down missiles that were attacking our embassy earlier today? They were able to shoot down the missiles? What's that? The most important fucking building in all of America, the Pentagon, was like, come on in, Flight 50 buttfuck, and fly into us. We'll never see it coming. Oh, we're just the Pentagon. We'll never see the plane coming and... We'll never try to stop it. We won't shoot down a plane. We won't try to stop it. Well, just come on and crash into the Pentagon. It's okay. It's just the Pentagon. It's WWE Raw. We'll just bring the legends out again. That worked last time. It didn't work, but let's just do it again. I'll bring the legends out. Is everybody in this fucking country a mongoloid retard but me? What is going on in this place? I'm sorry, George Bush. I'm sorry, we did 9/11, brah. I hate to break it to you. There's no fucking way we didn't. And I don't know what the fuck this COVID shit is. It's killing people, obviously. I think we made that too. I think we did it. We made it. It's fucking, we made it. We made the fucking virus and unleashed it on the whole world. This is on purpose.
Somebody definitely made it.
Somebody made it and unleashed it on the world. And somebody knows that somewhere. Lots of people know that. I'm not out of my fucking mind anymore. This can't be this retarded. All right? 6,000 pages in 10 minutes. You signed off on it. Why the fuck is this weird fuck shit in the fucking COVID bill? You dumb fucking cunts who work for us, but you all keep voting for him for some reason. Fuck this place. Fuck this country. Fuck this world. Fuck everybody. You stupid fucking idiots. Fuck the WWE. Fuck Vince. Fuck Stephanie's breasts. Fuck this whole fucking thing. Fuck you, WWE. You didn't listen to me 6 years ago, 7 years ago, 8 years ago, 10 years ago. Go watch the rants. I told you it was coming, and I told you why and how it didn't work and how it could work. And then you fucked up, 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 you fucked up. 5 million, 4 million, 3 million, 2 million, 1.5 million. And the re-rees in the chat, like always, oh, ratings don't really matter that much anymore. Ratings don't really matter that much anymore. It really don't matter that much anymore, y'all. There's YouTube and look, they don't. Nobody watches cable. Oh, what's this? They're tarping off the fucking arena because people aren't going to the show because they're not watching the show because the ratings do matter because they mean who is watching the show, and now they're tarping off big fucking amounts of the building. And now there's COVID, so who cares anyway? But they did tarp it off. And now you're losing in the demo to a company that lets the wrestlers decide what they're going to do in their little fucking circus act of AEW Dynamite. And they go out there and they just go, let's try this. This is weird. We're crazy. We don't know what the fuck we're doing. You're fucking losing to that. You're WWE, Vince McMahon. You took the company public, you fucking puppet-headed fucking Geppetto jack-off. I'm gonna fucking lose my fucking mind. I'm gonna stick this finger. Vince, if I ever fucking see you, go ahead. I dare you to hire me. I'll poke you in the fucking eye with this finger. I'm gonna poke you in the fucking eye with this fucking finger, you fuck. I'm going to
stick it up your ass
the
first,
fuck
you get
out of
pink
you.
Eye.
Go ahead and try to make me puke like draws. Go ahead and try to do it. He's gonna puke. Yeah, I'm going to puke too, Vince. Blah, all
Show
over
me
your
me
fucking
puke.
Face. All over your fucking face, Vince, is where I'm going to puke. Blah, blah, you fucking idiot.
I legit started watching Raw in the shower, trying to help my headache, and, you know, it just got worse from there. I was like hoping that after last night they would do something big. You figure when they respond to these rating fiasco disaster moments, they usually try and march out the McMahons, as we've seen time and time again, and they'll make some big announcement or call-ups from NXT. So I was waiting to see if there was going to be any surprise people coming up from NXT. How desperate do they get? Do they throw Undisputed Era on there? You know, how drastic does Vince feel he needs to be in order to save the ratings? And then I laughed to myself. I said, how long until, you know, in this show are they going to announce that next week for New Year's Eve is going to be a Stone Cold Legends night? And then they said it later on in the show. Oh, it is Legends night. And it's 2 weeks, from. Oh, my God. I was just joking. But so far they've got Hulk Hogan, Ric Flair, Kurt Angle, Beth Phoenix, Tori Wilson, Big Show, Jacqueline, Booker T, Sergeant Slaughter, Jeff Jarrett, Jimmy Hart, Ivory, Carlito, Boogeyman, Melina, Mark Henry, and Alicia Fox, and Tatanka. I didn't know Carlito was, a legend. Certainly, Boogeyman.
I mean, I hate to be, a sick person here, but I hope Tatanka rapes, Fox. I hope Tatanka ends up raping Fox at the hotel, and he goes to jail. How about that?
Yeah, I could see that happening. You know,
I think you could. I
think
there's
enough
that,
backstage
listen,
cameras. And
if someone's gonna rape somebody, it's definitely Tatanka.
Yeah. Oh, definitely. And it's either Alicia Fox or Tori Wilson. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, I'm going with he's gonna do Alicia Fox because she's gonna make it seem like she's a whore. But then when they get to the hotel, she's gonna be like, "Wait, no, I don't want to fuck you. I just wanted to party. I thought we were gonna party." And he's like, "Yeah, I thought we were gonna party." And then she's like, "No, not
you
like
get
that."
All weird.
What the fuck?
And holds her down and
yeah. And then he gets crazy and like loses his mind over the fact that it's not gonna happen, and he holds her down, and that's what happens. And listen,
stop it! Stop it! Stop raping me! Stop raping me, Tatanka! Ah!
Ah! I would love to see everybody boycott that Raw. That would be great if they had some of the worst ratings on Legends night, just to see that people don't give a shit for the Legends.
Oh, my God. Stop raping her, Tatanka. Stop it. You guys are legends. What are you doing? You're legends. Stop this. You're supposed to be legends. This is not funny. Rape isn't funny. Remember Sammy Guevara said he was going to rape Sasha Banks? Come on, stop it. No. Stop. No. This is sick. This is sick! Oh my goodness gracious,
damn dirty
no.
Bastard. Hopefully the cops are on their way.
I hope to talk. Oh my God.
Oh, that doesn't sound
oh
good.
Oh my God, you hear that? He calls that little whistling boy.
Oh.
Oh no. This is getting God. Worse. I can't believe this. Oh no. That move's called the tomahawk.
Oh, God.
Oh, no. He just did little foot, small hair.
Is he yelling he's going to scalp her?
Now he's doing Rise of the Sun. He's doing Rise of the Sun unwillingly on Alicia Fox. Stop this. Stop this now.
He said he's going to make smoke signals out of her pubic hair?
No, this is really sick right now. I haven't seen the war dance done like this since 1905.
What's he yelling? You want to sit in my teepee?
Oh my God! He's pulling out ears of corn right now.
I think they call it maize, Joe.
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry. Anyway, yeah. So listen, I don't think Tatanka and Alicia Fox should be anywhere near the same hotel during the Legends situation or coming up on Raw.
Oh,
really scary.
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
That's fucking sick. I'm sorry. That's sick. That's
a little bit disgusting. Of the bubbly.
That's it.
Pancakes, 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 pancakes.
I hear the Roman theme.
Pancakes, 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 pancakes,
pancakes. Spaz Phoenix Podcast, happy birthday. And thank you for the donation, Spaz Phoenix Podcast. Check him out. Give him some love. Thank you, sir. Legends Night's going to be amazing. No doubt about it. Hope you hit that like button down below. Hit that sub button if you're new. You don't want to miss this shit.
Super chat. Super chat.
Alexa Bliss is the Fiend savior.
Yeah, that seems like she's going to resurrect him, to be honest.
That's kind of what we thought would be what kind of happens. We were predicting that last night. One of the things I thought of earlier, I said...
A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
And we'll find
out.
Bubbly? Look at this stuff. A little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
I was going to start doing YouTube in April, but I think I will take my 600 and start selling cocaine and weed again. No, wait, they're going to legalize weed and tax it.
They're going to legalize weed and tax it. I mean, yeah, they are in Massachusetts. It's so taxed here, it's unbelievable. By the way, I'm starting to feel a lot better, bro.
That's good.
I had a raging headache.
How long have I told you to go to the goddamn doctors that you need antibiotics?
Well, no, I don't. No, I mean like earlier today. Last couple hours, I was having a migraine. Oh shit.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get myself a 1967 Cadillac Eldorado convertible, hot pink with whale skin hubcaps and all leather cow interior and big brown baby seal eyes for headlights. Yeah, and I'm going to drive in that baby at 115 miles per...
Yeah, let's go. Let's do it. Thank you, sir, for the $10 Spaz Phoenix. Yeah, I'm ready tonight. Folks, I'd like to sing a song about the American dream. About me, about you, about the way our American hearts beat way down in the bottom of our chests. About that special feeling we get in the cockles of our hearts. Maybe below the cockles, maybe in the subcockle area, maybe in the liver, maybe in the kidneys, maybe even in the colon, we don't know.
Just a regular Joe with a regular job. I'm your average white suburbanite slob. I like football and porno and books about war. I got an average house with a nice hardwood floor. My wife, my job, my kids and my car. My feet on the table and a Cuban cigar. But sometimes that just ain't enough to keep a man like me interested.
Oh no, uh-uh.
And I gotta go out and have fun at someone else's expense.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I drive really slow in the ultra-fast lane while retards behind me are going insane. I'm an asshole.
Oh, yeah.
And I use public toilets and I piss on the seats. I walk around in the summertime saying, how about this heat? I'm an asshole.
He's an asshole. Yo, 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 yo. The world's biggest asshole.
Well, sometimes I park in handicapped spaces while handicapped people make handicapped faces. And then an asshole. Laughing and raving and carrying on. Maybe they're right when they tell me I'm right.
fuck that next part. Ladies and gentlemen, back to the Raw review. Jake, you're about to make a point. You're about to make a point when the donation came in, Jake, and it interrupted you, Jake. So go ahead, boy, and let me know what you were going to say before you got interrupted.
What was I saying?
I don't know, but you were saying something.
Yeah.
Woo-hoo! It's gone. You were saying something, brother. Bring it on, something. Brother. Oh.
What would you think if they had Randy Orton? It would be a very short thing, just to get to the Rumble, and then we could resurrect the Fiend. But Randy, because he killed the Fiend, now would see the Fiend. Like, he'd be in becoming the Fiend, because yep. now it'd be, like, infected in his mind.
Well, see, that's kind of what I was getting cool. at with, like, sort of like the Cell with Jennifer Lopez. Like,
yeah,
there's
yeah.
there's this nightmare, like Freddy, Nightmare on Elm Street thing going on mm-hmm. in Randy's head.
Mr. Krug, yeah.
And so, like, they cut to this scene of, like, Bray Wyatt, the Fiend, laying in either fire or, like, there's fire around him, but it's like the fire around him is the burning ashes and stuff are moving in slow motion and in like 60 frames per second, but Bray Wyatt is moving around in like 14 frames per second, and he's saying things, and when he says these things, Randy's hearing them. So after you hear Bray Wyatt or the Fiend saying this crazy shit, it's always cutting to Randy, who's like kind of like doesn't know what's going on. Yeah, you can do all kinds of things with this that is crazy. And
that would be great, and that's why I was hoping tonight. Like, it was good. It was the best thing on Raw, but it could have been so much more spicy, explosive, hot, fiery. Your choice of words here. And I did like that Alexa was throwing those puns out. You know, he could be at a tanning salon, or he's at the beach. I hope he doesn't get sunburnt. You know, maybe he's eating his favorite food, which is barbecue. You know, I all that stuff just made me chuckle because it fits with her character well.
Because she was so good. If it was somebody else delivering those lines, it'd be like, "You, this is retarded." But she
if
was
that
good.
Was Charlotte or even Peyton Royce, it would have flopped. It would have failed.
Exactly.
And I like how some people were like, "Oh, maybe just wait until Easter to bring him back, since they killed the Fiend so close to Christmas." But.
Dude, I'm getting so many video clips of my ranting tonight.
Of you just,
to me
you're gonna get
on
a
Twitter
one clips because that first one was epic.
We ain't never going. This one's for Larry Funk tonight, brother. I'm losing Hell my yeah. mind. Friday night's Larry Funk tribute night, but tonight Larry would have enjoyed this.
Larry.
You know what I'd like to do, Joe? I'd love to fucking fuck goddamn Vince McMahon and fucking throw him off Titan Tower and break his head. Like, that's what Larry Funk would say if he was here, motherfucker. He would tell you to fuck himself like he told the Road Dogg to fuck himself, motherfucker. I'm losing my voice. My fucking goiter or whatever the fuck is in my neck is probably growing right now. But, yeah.
You got to take more of that, you know, Christmas special. Get yourself more of the snow.
I'm going to take fucking goddamn fucking formaldehyde. I'm going to drink a bottle of formaldehyde and fucking die. That's how much Raw is.
Just replace your
me.
Blood with it, and you'll be
oh
all set.
God,
to live
bro.
Forever.
The lymph nodes are swollen. Dude, Leah has a fucking infection. She has an ear infection. She finally got to the doctor today.
Thankfully.
I got one of those things. I looked in her ear. I go, your ears, you have an ear infection. Guaranteed.
Yeah, and you can just tell when
but,
it's
but we need the referral.
Red.
So I'm like, go to the doctor, and she went to the doctor, ear infection. So she has an ear infection. She's on amoxicillin. I have a sinus infection. I'm on amoxicillin. Like, I don't know what the fuck happened to us, but we both have the same fucking thing going on. And we're walking around like, ooh, and it's like, what the fuck's... And then my tooth fell apart today. But it was the root canal tooth, so I don't feel any pain actually right now because I guess...
That's good.
I guess when...
That's
I mean,
why
they,
it fell apart, because that piece never got finished.
Yeah, so. Yeah, and they ripped the root out, so there's no nerve. They ripped the fucking nerve out. So I'm like, what? I'm like, oh my God, it's my tooth is hurting. Oh, it's my just... My, no, it's just my jaw. But yeah,
mine
man.
Mine broke more in the back from all the vomiting. It's killing me, but I mean, I just gotta get it out eventually.
Yeah, bro. I feel like I'm on. You know, maybe the fucking shit they gave me. Maybe I'm on crack tonight. I don't fucking
give
know.
It a hell yeah.
Why did Jackson Ryker get punished for supporting Trump on Twitter? Vince is a Trump supporter.
Hail metal forever. Thank you, man. I don't know, man. Because people are fucking retards in this country.
It's because I don't think he did anything wrong either. It was the timing of what he was saying made it seem like he was anti-BLM and
yeah, that's what it was.
People really went into that sentiment of it and made an uproar against him. It wasn't so much the positive Trump, but the anti side of his statement that it
shit
was
bomb.
Presumed to take.
I rather watch you for 3 hours complaining about everything than Raw. I just finished watching Raw. Holy shit, thank God for DVR. I think I watched the whole Raw in 20 minutes. Shit is fucking boring.
Wow, you are so lucky, bro. I literally watched just about everything tonight. I did take 20 minutes off because I was doing stuff with my kids and doing something with Leah and like cleaning up some stuff. And then like I just went, I don't give a fuck. I missed 20 minutes. I don't know what it was. It probably sucked. Everything I saw before it and after it sucked, so I'm assuming it sucked. There really wasn't much to talk about tonight. It was just all bullshit regurgitation.
Shit,
there's nothing
bomb
to break down, really.
Not how I wanted to spend the eve of my birthday, this vomit of a Raw, and the news that my province is confirmed a full lockdown till the end of January. Thanks for the love, JCS Army. Bring the riots, bring the comet.
Bring the comet. I didn't even get to see the fucking Christmas. Of course I don't get to see the Christmas star. Fucking 800 years since it's been this visible. No Christmas star. You know why? Clouds. The fucking sky's too cloudy. I figured, I knew right away where Southwest was. I knew exactly where to look. I know where the compass is now in my location. Couldn't see it, of course. Only in 2020. If it was 2022.
Yeah, there was nothing but clouds here, too.
I
want to
suck you off tonight.
Oh, shit.
I
want
to suck you off tonight. I'm wondering if it'd be all right if I goddamn suck you off tonight. I will suck you off all night. I will suck you off tonight. And I wanna suck and fuck and gargle and snarkle and snobble and fuggle and stubble and goggle and
cockmeister.
Suck me off.
Cockmeister.
Suck me off.
Cock.
Tonight's Raw, I give 2/10 definition. It's the cock that's trash. It's the cock looks like a clitoris.
Ooh.
It's the cock that you've been talking to your girlfriend about, and when you have sex for the first time with her, she laughs and it disintegrates in front of her eyes.
You absolutely gonna get the cock tonight. Let me tell you something, son. Let me tell you something, Cockmeister Daddy. Let me tell you something, Cockmeister. Cockmeister Brother, I give Raw 2/10 too, man. Cockmeister.
Super
you, my daddy.
Party.
You're my daddy, Cockmeister.
Have you heard about the reverse exorcism? It's when a demon has to appear to pull the priest out of a child.
Oh, my God. Yeah, they're going to be performing that on my family in the next couple of weeks. It's going to be great. WWE legends Ric Flair and Hulk Hogan. By the way, Ric Flair does not look like this in the photo anymore. I don't think Hogan looks like that either, but definitely Ric Flair does not look like this, but nice try, you know? I mean, come on.
Especially with all the legends that they have on there. Beth Phoenix, obviously, because she's in TNA, but Kurt Angle, Torrey Wilson, Big Show, Jacqueline, Booker T, Sergeant Slaughter.
Right.
It's not like this amazing list.
What is this?
Dunkachino
Robertsky!
What's my name?
Dunkachino.
It's a whole new game.
Dunkachino.
You want creamy goodness? I'm your friend. Say hello to my chocolate blend.
That was weird, but anyway, Merry Christmas, Joe and Jake DeMarco.
Yes.
Just upload a Santa Claus that's non-WWE or AU or wrestling for that matter.
Well,
it's Christmas, show it.
You're going
you
to jail.
You love it. Hell yeah.
You're going to jail for 10 years. You are going to jail for 10 years. You're going to jail for 10 years.
Where is he?
Tell me! Don't tell me! My Bobbio! My Bobbio! Are you kidding me?
If anybody wants to know what I'd sound like on commentary, it's about right.
Tell me! Don't tell me!
Lines up.
Dude, Married with Children, where Santa ends up crashing in their backyard, is one of the funniest things. Because
that's so good.
It's the fucking fact that the whole episode is building to Santa, and then the TV is like, folks, we've lost Santa Claus. There's a problem, you know. And then it's like the fact that they come on and go, we don't know where Santa is. And then he lands in their backyard, breaks his neck or whatever, and a dummy just crashes down. Like, and the fact that it's clearly a dummy is the funniest fucking thing ever. Like, I'm sorry, man. That Married with Children episode, I watch that every Christmas. That is my...
Oh, yeah, that's one of my go-tos as well. People like the Christmas story. I love that one. And I rewatched one of my favorite episodes when the aliens come.
Oh my god.
What the shit fuck? Bomb.
I would rape Fox and Mandy Rose at the same time. I'll rape them in the asshole.
Oh.
Make their asshole bleed. Jeez. And put their blood has paint face.
Oh my
those
god.
Those CUNTs will not regret this think tan fucking Indian cock, that's for sure.
Oh, come on, Tatanka.
Yike.
All those extra, like, that's where he's stabbing her unwillingly with his dick right there.
Yeah, oh, absolutely. That's the penetration moment. Drew McIntyre is now on Cameo. He's doing it for WWE, though, specifically. So it's $400 for each personalized video.
Well, guess what? I got Drew McIntyre on my show plugging us for free!
Exactly.
No. So I don't think so.
And SmackDown was on Fox Sports 1 this past week due to Fox being occupied. They went ahead and they drew over 1 million viewers. So that was good for SmackDown. They haven't done that before. The highest they've earned is 881,000.
In what? In what show?
On SmackDown this past Friday.
And sound effect.
They did 800,000 people?
They did 1.03 million.
That's terrible.
Not for Fox Sports 1. That's really good.
Oh,
for them.
I thought you were talking about on Fox, regular Fox.
Yeah, no, because SmackDown. They had to be on Fox Sports 1.
So. Oh. I get it. Look at this.
Like, have to give a straight face, you know, character-wise. I said to him,
look at this. We talked to him for free, you fucking $400 payers.
I had to watch the promo we did before, because I just heard about it, and I watched them in the ring, and I was like, oh my god. And we had no real time to rehearse, and Matt and I tend to go out and ad-lib a lot of it, and he does all these wacky faces and sound effects when he's talking to you. And I'd like have to keep a straight face, you know, character-wise. So I said to him after we finished it, I was like, Matt, I'm so glad I watched you before I went out there, or I would have cracked up. Like, it's so hard to keep a straight face, but this thing is going to get so over, because I'm already popping for it. And when it gets over with the boys, it's definitely going to go over with.
Notice how Drew actually talking in his regular accent here.
Super
yeah.
He's not... He pronounces stuff
the
way different.
The episode where
now.
Bundy makes the God shoes with the built-in socks and the toes.
Oh my god!
Hash God shoes.
Oh my god, dude! Spaz Phoenix. The episode where Bundy can't remember the song he heard, and he just goes around screaming it to everybody like, you don't know the song, something him, and he just keeps going something him, like, and they fucking like, oh my god, bro, dude, Married with Children is fucking hilarious, especially like.
Such a great show. Still That's, timeless.
Like about half of it, like if not more than half of it, but half of it is unbelievably gold. And
oh,
then,
yeah.
Then there's like, you know, the other half that's like okay, and then there's some of like at least two seasons worth of like not very good, but it's really like there's at least, if you added it all up together, there's at least six amazingly solid seasons, like crazy good.
What else
fucking
we got?
Shit.
Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it. That's
Want
it.
Some bubbly? Look at this stuff. Oh, a little bit of the bubbly.
That's it.
Watching Raw was like watching Bullfag rape Crystal while Tommy Cracker Jack has his 2-inch cracker pecker hanging out her mouth. Feed me whores.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, my God. Good Lord. Hey, they're going to tax us more. Team Biden's ready to stick you with the carbon tax, which increases the power costs. And intrusiveness of the government in our lives. That's not good. AJ Adams watching Raw was like watching a fucking Tatanka rape Alicia Fox, which is horrible. We don't want that to happen. But I'm telling you, keep Tatanka away from Alicia Fox. Not saying it's going to happen. Not saying he ever did it. I'm just saying.
It's wise to not even tempt fate.
Don't exactly. When that Indian Native American smells like her ass chocolate, he's going to fucking come. Like,
he's going to want to turn chocolate into fudge.
Oh, my God, bro. He's going to rub his little fucking hammer toe. Let me tell you something. He's going to rub his hammer toe. J-Rod, what's up, bro? Didn't your donation play already, or did it not happen?
Keeps telling him there's an error.
Oh, yeah. I don't see anything.
Super chat party.
I don't see it, brother.
Marcy Darcy was a warning for the Karens, the Susans, the SJWs, and fem-Nazis of today.
Oh, yeah.
Who didn't listen.
Yeah, really.
And she's kind of really that character. if you go,
she really, yeah,
she had a problem with Ed O'Neill at the end, bro. She was like, well, she's a lesbian and got married, and I guess because Ed O'Neill was like a, you know, would make fun of it, like for real, like in real life would make fun of her being a lesbian a bit, but he liked her, but he, you know what I mean, he liked her, but he was like, oh, you're gonna scissor later or whatever, and so she didn't invite him to the wedding in real life. Because she was like, ah, he was just, he would, you would just make jokes and shit and make fun of us. So that was like almost like the real character. It's crazy.
Yeah. That's, you know, a nice insulting way to say it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sue me, Ryback. I'm going to fuck you in your ass, Ryback.
I'm going to finish you.
Get the fuck out of the chat, Ryback. Get out of the chat, Ryback. You scumbag, Ryback.
Clout hungry bastard.
You clout hungry cunt. Fuck you and never come back. You disgusting roided up fuck. Get out of my chat.
Well, it is Christmas week, and, you know, even the main event, I didn't think it was too intrusive with the holiday stuff. Like, it didn't go that usual horrifically silly route. You know, AJ got slammed onto the table that had eggnog on it, but they weren't having an all-out food fight. And, you know, the kendo sticks were wrapped like candy canes. So it was okay, but it wasn't like, you know, where they have to use presents to battle each other or Santa gets involved or,
right.
You know, so thankfully it wasn't the Miracle on 34th Street fight type matches that they usually do. I didn't mind this, you know, for the, I didn't want it to be the main event, but the match itself was okay. It had a few decent moments. It's just the fact that we've seen these people fight for so long now. This feud feels just extra crispy. It's just overdone at this point. No one wants it. Just be done with it. I can't wait for them to move on. SmackDown tomorrow is being taped, so they're taping on Tuesday night for the Christmas episode this Friday. It's a stacked show. Sami Zayn has an IC title match against Big E. Roman Reigns is taking on Kevin Owens in a steel cage match for the title. Also, Charlotte Flair and Asuka are defending their tag team titles on SmackDown as well. So there's three title matches right there.
Right.
So it's going to be a really excellent episode of SmackDown, it sounds like, in theory, on paper.
You know, I think it will be, it will probably be not very fun, but like better than this, obviously. Better than Raw. It will be like, oh, that was okay, nice, it's Christmas, whatever. And that's what it will be.
Super Chat Party.
Save the world. Punch a feminist in her used sloppy loose fish taco pocket.
Oh my God. Dude, taco pocket.
Taco Tuesday.
You know,
Taco
I interviewed pocket. Tatanka once.
Choco Taco Pocket. Now you're talking.
Yeah. Let it drip. Let it drip, drip, drip. Let it drip. All right, listen, there's not much else to say. We're going to play another donation. I'm probably going to be done. I'm probably going to get out of here. It's nothing else to say. I think I've ranted and flipped out. I'm going to lose my voice. I'm sick as fuck.
I did want to mention Kevin Green passed away, unfortunately. You know, everyone, I'm sure, remember him from WCW and
wrestling
there.
Oh, my God, another person? What the fuck?
Yep. And, you know, if you don't know him from his short time in wrestling, he was also a pro, you know, football player. He was in the Hall of Fame there. So he teamed with, who is it? Piper and Flair against... I forget.
I want to say 1995.
Nash, Hall, and Six. I think it was.
It was 95 or maybe it was 96, actually, now that I think about it. Maybe it was 97.
Slamboree in May of 97. Yep. Nash, Hall, and Six taking on Piper, Flair, and, yeah, Green. So
that's crazy. But, I mean, I once after Larry Funk passing away, you know, nothing's crazy anymore to me. You know, it's all craziness. Casey is Raw said, Jake, will you marry me? Think about it. I got all the video games you can dream of. You can be my player, too. Just kidding. And then he says he wants to fuck you in the face.
Damn. I'm honored that he wants to marry me, but then he backs out of it and says he wants you. Oof.
Very strange.
He's not getting my cookies.
Whoa,
that's all there is to
really?
It.
Really?
No,
you're not
going to
give
sharing.
Up your cookies?
I'm not sharing. Not anymore.
That's different because normally you're all about, like, you know, showing cookies off.
Yeah, yeah. I'm all about it. Here's some sprinkles. Here's some icing. Let's get it on. But no, no, no more cookies. Not for Casey.
You're going to keep them hidden?
I have to.
You're going to keep your cookies hidden like that.
I have to keep them hidden. I'm going to put those cookies back in the cookie jar.
I mean, that's some crazy shit.
I'm telling you, that's what it came down to. Flip-flopping back and forth.
That's fucking crazy.
No more cookies for Casey.
Cookies for Casey. That's fucking hilarious. There probably would be something like cookies for Casey, too.
Yeah.
there's going to be killings for Casey next.
Join the walk for cookies for Casey.
Well, in classic
raise money.
In classic fashion, my computer is actually frying itself, and I lost the whole screen and everything else.
So oh, nice! Everything's freezing.
Yep. I'm either hacked or computer's broken or somebody's DDoSing. I don't know what's going on, but it's definitely something is fucked, and I can't see anything. Everything's frozen. So goodbye, everybody. Good night. I think I'm being probably a DDoS. I'm not sure, but whatever.
Probably getting attacked again.
Yep. Probably the FBI. Good night, everybody. I'm going to end the stream. The terrorists win, all right? Terrorists are going to win. Good night. Thanks to Jake. Thanks to everybody else. I can't see the chat anymore because my whole computer's frozen, but I think I'm still broadcasting. So good night. Hit me up on Twitter at JCS Commentary. Hit up the Patreon on patreon.com/JoeCroninShow. Got a bunch of stuff coming this week. Thanks to everybody.
J-Rod said, screw Vince, rip WWE. Thank you for that super chat as well, J-Rod.
Oh, J-Rod, thanks, man. I can't see it. Screw Vince. Yo, J-Rod, thank you, man, for giving that extra stuff. Thank you, brother. J-Rod ending it, making me wet.
What have you got to show in your
sexy
fucking DMs? Your fucking DMs.
All right, I'm going
to
reboot my computer.
Show?
Good night.
That's going to expose me.
Go back, enjoy the rants.